Emotions ran high in Parliament today as our leaders delivered formal condolences to the victims of the Bali bombings in the run-up to the 20th anniversary of the attack. It comes as plans for a permanent peace park at the site of the bombing remain on hold.
This is the latest peace park plan for the block of land where the Sari Club once was. It's the site of our worst peacetime atrocity. 88 Australians lost their lives here. But as we approach the 20th anniversary of the bombings, it's still in limbo.
I was told pre-election that the Prime Minister said that he won't walk away from this, so I'm going to hold the Prime Minister to his word.
Today, Anthony Albanese was overcome with emotion in Parliament, delivering a formal motion of condolence to the Bali victims ahead of the anniversary.
We will commemorate them from Bali to Coogee, Dulwich Hill to Perth. We will think of everyone who never came home. We will think of all the survivors we have lost since. We hold on to their names and faces, and we will never let them fade.
Honouring too those who saved lives, the medics, volunteers and police who worked tirelessly to thwart terrorism.
And prevent many Bali-like attacks from taking place around the world, including in our own country.
They also paid tribute to our own 10 News First journalist Nick Way, who last week lost his battle with motor neuron disease. Nick inspired the Bali Peace Park concept.
On the 12th of October, one face that will be missing is Nick Way. Nick died last Friday and I know his presence will be greatly missed.
In the two decades since the blast ripped through the Sari Club, the site here remains derelict. Nothing has changed. But for those caught up in the Bali bombing shockwaves, some of the changes in their lives will astound you. Revealed tonight on the 10 News First special.
I think all of us, as we step back and look down the tunnel of time of 20 years, just spare a thought for those people who've lived those 20 years without their loved ones. And I'm a great believer in each and every one of us working towards a society that we're proud of, based on the integrity of each and every one of us, not abdicated to people who make decisions to go to war or make decisions to cause such terror, that we all need to stand up maybe and be counted. And in doing that, maybe we will have a society, communities that we're proud to hand on to our kids and our grandkids.
Well, Ali Donaldson joins me at the desk. Such vivid memories, Ali. Gosh, it makes you emotional, doesn't it? Now, shockwaves, the Bali bombings, airs tonight here on 10. What can viewers expect?
Sandra, these are the real people and their real stories, not just what happened on the night, which is compelling enough in itself, but what's happened to them over the past two decades. And it's so intriguing. So many of them have turned that night of terror into a story of hope. They've saved lives, they continue to save lives, they emotionally have reached out to each other and many others. And I think there's a lot we can learn from these people, and they've given us exclusive insights into that, as well as exclusive vision inside the Sari Club. Now, this is extremely rare. We've uncovered it during this process. So it takes you right into where that bomb went off that night and what those people went through. I think it makes for compelling visions.
It does. I look forward to seeing it. And, of course, the viewers reacting and responding, and a podcast to accompany it as well for further updates. All right. Thanks, Ellie.